Good morning, everybody. So this is, I think it's actually the first SECO-ASSIST research seminar, where basically the goal of today is twofold. It's having the different partners of the SECO-ASSIST research project present their current, ongoing, or post-research on the topic. And also have some invited speakers, in this case Alexander Sterling from the University of Eindhoven, and later on in the day there will be Jesus González Barahona from Madrid, who will also do an invited presentation. So let me first, before starting with the presentation sessions, I will explain a little bit the project for those who don't know it yet. So the project is actually it's a project that has been financed by the FWO in Flanders and the FNRS in Wallonia. I have an animation of this in the FNRS part. So basically you can more or less see the language barriers, which I try to make really linear. It's a much more
Yes.
Brussels is still only active. It was too difficult to find the picture.
Is it a political statement or is it geographical inaccuracy?
Maybe
I did a
picture of the camera.
Yes.
I just did a linear regression analysis on the frontier.
Yeah, speaking about regression in the political context, that doesn't sound good.
So, in the French part of Belgium, there is two participating universities in this Excellence of Science project. There's Clemence, who is the main coordinator of the project, and the University of Namur. And in the French part of Belgium, there is Bayer at Brussels, and there is Antwerp, where we have representatives present today, who will both give a presentation about their work. The main project coordinators of the project are myself in Mons, Anthony Gray in Amberg, Koen de Roo in Brussels, and Sarah in Antwerp. Today's theme will be on software evolution, software ecosystems, and open source software. So just for those who don't know what a software ecosystem is, I guess there will be very few, but at least what my definition of software ecosystem is, it's basically it's a combination of two different things. First of all, we have a collection of different software projects or software components that are all interdependent, interconnected, and together they form some kind of coherent whole. This could be a distribution, it could be a packaging ecosystem, it can have many different forms. And on the other hand, there is a community of collaborators, typically the developers of all of these software components, but it can be much more than just developers. Everyone who is involved in these projects somehow will be a collaborator in the ecosystem. So this means that in a software ecosystem, there is basically two major things. First of all, the size of an ecosystem, it's a collection of many different projects, so it's much larger than your typical software system. And secondly, the fact that there is these social and technical aspects that are both equally important when you want to understand and evolve and maintain your software ecosystem over time. And so that's basically where the SECO-ASSIST project is revolving around. So if I can capture or try to summarize the main research goals of the SECO-ASSIST project. This is what we promised to do in our project proposal. So that basically there is some fundamental goals, because it's fundamental science, but also some applied goals. So fundamentally, basically we want to understand, we want to study and understand software ecosystems and how they evolve over time, focusing on the social technical characteristics of these ecosystems. And to this, by doing this, we want to see what is the health of a software system, what is the quality of a software ecosystem and all its components, and how can we increase their resilience and sustainability over time. So basically, it's part of the goals is to do some empirical analysis about these software ecosystems to gain a deeper understanding. And once we have this deeper understanding, we can try to provide new prediction models and recommendation models to try to improve the quality and the health of these ecosystems over time. So basically, this brings me to the applied goal, which is based on all of these findings and prediction models and recommendation models. If we have those, we could turn them into automated tools that help the developers of the individual components of the ecosystem part of the ecosystem as a whole to increase their quality, productivity, resilience over time. So this is the overall goals. The overall goals are focused on both the social and the technical characteristics. So if I narrow down these goals, the social goals would be trying to improve the social health of the ecosystems over time. I think this is mostly the, like, this was the key research goal of the most partner in the project. And the second goal is, of course, focus on the technical characteristics over time. For the social health characteristics, there is many different types of things we would like to analyze, so this list is not limitative. For example, what are the most important contributors of an open source ecosystem? How can we avoid these contributors that they leave from the ecosystem if they are real key stakeholders in the ecosystem? How can we attract new contributors to the ecosystem? How can we actually predict that some important contributors will abandon the ecosystem, and how can we find proper replacements for them? How can we identify which contributors are toxic? Toxic contributors, they might have some kind of negative effect, because if you start have negative behavior, it might propagate over other persons, leading to multiple people that will be driven away from the ecosystem. And how can we avoid all of these things, or the specific techniques or specific guidelines that we could use to increase, for example, the diversity of the team to avoid this? I think Alexander will talk about diversity in his talk, so he will present you all of this. So this is the social aspect. For technical aspects, there is also a lot of things to do. For example, taking into account the social technical ecosystem and the fact that we have a dependency network of many different components that are connected together, we want to see how can the typical software development testing process, how can this be lifted to the ecosystem level. So there, I think in part, will be a presentation in the afternoon by the Antwerp partner. I don't know to which extent will exactly cover this, but the software testing components of the project will be covered by mostly by the Antwerp partner in collaboration with the other partners. How can we increase the productivity and quality of software ecosystems in terms of reusable software libraries? That's really the key for the time break from the Brussels partner. Related to the software libraries, how can we increase the software maintainability as a whole? For example, for facilitating upgrading to new versions, migrating from one version of a library to another version of another library. And then for the Namur partner, it's mostly related to data-intensive software systems, and see how everything that's related to databases and database technology fits within this ecosystem goal. So that's basically just a very brief summary of the SECO-ASSIST project. But now let's get back to in English. I would say in French. In English, let's get back to our ship. I don't know if you know this expression in English; it doesn't exist. But let's get back to the main topic of today, which is the presentation that I'm going to introduce now. So first up is just the schedule of today. In the morning, we'll have two invited presentations. The first one will be given by Alexander Surovik in just a couple of minutes on gender diversity in open source software development. It's more than gender diversity, it's also other types of diversity.
No, it's mostly gender diversity. If you want to ask about other types of diversity, yeah, I'll try to answer for
that. Okay. Then the second presentation in this morning will be by Daniel Liucci from the PUB, about mobile app developers and the updating of third-party libraries. I'm not going to say anything more about this because you will hear it soon from him himself. After that, we will have a long lunch break with I hope that the sandwiches will look as good as the ones in this picture. I hope there will not be people like this guy eating sandwiches for us. Then the afternoon schedule, there is again first two presentations. The first one is by Jesus González Barahona from Madrid, who I'm excited to listen to this talk. It's a topic I haven't really heard a lot about, and I'm interested to hear about, because it's about the new GDPR rules and how this affects us as researchers who are doing data analysis and software quality findings. So what should we take into account in the light of this GDPR? And then there is Enrique from the University of Antwerp, Enrique Rocha, who is a postdoc at Antwerp, who will be focusing on the testing aspect in software ecosystems. Again, after this, there is another coffee break at 3. We will see, maybe there can be some extra smaller presentations that we will fit in if some of the presentations take less time than foreseen. So we can adapt the schedule slightly in that case. And then after that, there is Le Moment Sucre, where there will be, of course, I think I have it here, there is this nice booklet written by some guy, his name is Ahmed Zerouali, who will be defending his PhD at 6, the public PhD defense on the measurement framework for analyzing technical language of the source of the ecosystems. It's the person on the right. The person on the left is just his advisor.